But today I'm going to tell you about the German Yacht Terrier, also known as the German Hunting Terrier, which is a very special dog breed, multiple purposes. I will tell you something about why it's a special dog that is also FCI registered, so the federations that look into dog breeds for show purposes, so accept the dog breeds FCI in Europe. Other regions could have their own classification system, but if you look at that, the Yacht Terrier is one of the only working breeds, pure working breeds, also registered with the FCI. If you know others, please let me know. And, for example, the Smutgoed Fell Terrier that I have here on the other side of the line, my 11-month-old Giselle Estacato, is in the pedigree of the Yacht Terrier, the Fell Terrier is, but it's not FCI registered. It is a working breed, but it's not FCI registered. And perhaps you would say, yeah, the Belgian Malinois, that's an FCI registered breed that is also working, and you would be right. But if you would look at those that work, then you would see that those are Malinois X, and X stands for crosses. And as soon as you enter crosses, it's not an FCI registered breed anymore. It's just a cross. So you won't get an FCI pedigree with that. But, that's the tricky thing. Whereas a Yacht Terrier is both working, so, and both a purebred FCI registered breed. So that makes it quite special. Just think about that. Let's settle in your mind. So if you want to have a breed that is FCI registered and also a working breed, you could go that way. For me, it has little to no value because of the current development. But if those developments differ again or alter, it could be interesting again. The other way is that the Yacht Terrier can be shown. If you want to have your dog shown and tested on external features, that would be an opportunity, a possibility with the German Yacht Terrier. Again, for me also, there's little to no value. Hoi, goedemorgen. Hoi, hoi. Hoi. Doos weg. Zit spelen. So that's one. On the other hand, if you look at the work capabilities, the Yacht Terrier is not a diluted working dog. You could, for example, say, yeah, a draadhaar hunting dog is bred pure, so FCI registered, and is also a real hunting dog. Perhaps you're right, but if you compare that to, for example, a Yacht Terrier, the intensity of the Yacht Terrier is so much more. It's even on a different level compared to working Malinois. Even exceeds it, in my opinion. Yacht Terriers are that intense. And you could also say, yeah, there are huskies that are pulling sleds. Is that really working? That's one. And if you look at those that really work and win races, for example, are almost all husky crosses. So there's a big difference between the Siberian Husky, which is an FCI registered showbred dog, or the Alaskan Husky, which is a performance bred husky, which also includes hounds and side hounds, running dogs, to make it faster. So those are things to consider. If you look at the working capabilities of the German Yacht Terrier, it's one dog that can do all. Some of those have Labrador Retriever say, that's a working dog because it can retrieve something for me. A Yacht Terrier can also retrieve it for you. But what a Labrador doesn't, he won't attack a hawk, a swine, a big pig. It will just cower away. Whereas a German Yacht Terrier, albeit its little size, will just do it. Bay at it, keep it disentangled, if possible, nip it. It will do everything. If it has to track a blood trail, it will do it. If you want it to go underground to catch a fox, if it can enter the burrow, it will go. It's a really good all-rounder working dog, a hunting dog. It's a hunting dog elite. This is my Patterdale Terrier, also known as the smooth-coated Black Fell Terrier, which is an ur dog elite. It's also used on hog, but it's more a catch dog, so it won't be taunting as much as a German Yacht Terrier will do, which is like a more baying type of terrier. So it barks and attacks and then jumps back. This is more of a silent, strong dog type of terrier, so it will engage and try to hold. And some have like a mixed type, so they will do both, bay but also hold. And most Yacht Terriers will not only bay but also hold. But they have a little bit less strength as compared to their size, as compared to, for example, a Patterdale Terrier, which is more sturdy. So Patterdale Terrier is made to go to ground, so you put as much power in a small package as possible, whereas a Yacht Terrier also needs to cover big amounts of distance, so you need it also be a little bit lighter and sometimes even bigger if you specialize it on, for example, hawk hunting, wild pig hunting or swine hunting. And that made also the different breed spin-offs, for example the Westfalen Terrier was a spin-off of the Yacht Terrier, and also the Heide Terrier has much of its offspring giving away the Yacht Terrier phenotype, because that dog was the dog they strived for, only bigger, stronger and easier with other dogs. So what is hard about the Yacht Terrier with other dogs? They're very dominant. They will try to fight often. And if you use multiple dogs to hunt and they are fighting each other, that's not a nice thing to have. Also when they engage, for example, the swine, and if they also fight each other, when the swine is dead or something else occurs, that's not an easy thing. Also, they wanted to have a dog with a Heide Terrier that's easier in house, or easier suited for family life. Because as I mentioned, the Yacht Terrier is that intense type of dog that you have big troubles to keeping it as a pet. And the question is, with all working breed, should they be kept as a pet? I think the answer is, it can be done, but you need to give it lots of mental and physical exercise and give it something to do. If you do so, for the dog it doesn't matter that much. But if you don't, you will be in trouble. But even if you do so, I know a guy who also has nice Irish staffs, also some of the breeding that I did, or helped to collaborate with. He found out that the German Yacht Terrier is very intense and also messes up yellow dogs. Because a German Yacht Terrier, unlike for example Pattedale Terrier, doesn't hunt for you that much, it hunts for itself. It's like an alpha hunter. And if you have like a pack of those, it's like you release a pack of little raptors. And they will think for themselves, act for themselves, and hunt for themselves. It could be quite hard to change that. But it is, for those that really need that kind of dog, it's a very good dog. Is there nothing wrong with the German Yacht Terrier? Every breed has its drawbacks, of course. The thing is, the biggest drawback, in my opinion, for the German Yacht Terrier next to that is hard to use if you don't keep it outside and have it as a working dog. So it will always be busy. Eh? Also, in-house, it doesn't get easily in a rest phase, so it will exercise itself, which is nice, but it will also keep on going. Even if you have it like in kennels outside, it will keep moving. And some people really don't like that neurotic kind of thing. But yeah, it's a working breed, very intense, but next to those properties, the only real drawback, I think, that is plaguing the German Yacht Terrier, but I think it can be solved quite easily, is a small gene pool. So what happened? They vigorously selected those, and they wanted a certain color, the black and tan marking that you now see in all the German Yacht Terriers. But they used, for example, Fox Terriers and other terriers with different colorations, and so they had to select on color, and the first selections, those with the color they wanted, didn't work as good as they wanted. So they had to reselect, and also inbreed quite a bit to get where they wanted to be, and also a dog that really would work. Whereas those that didn't have that external features, did have the working capability, were excluded. And that is often the wrong thing to do, because it narrows the gene pool, even if you get good dogs, to quite a big degree. But they had a big, strong breeding program with different persons involved, big kennels, so that was still a good way to approach, and they had also different breeds to use, for example, a lot of Fox Terriers in there, in the Yacht Terrier. But also the Fell Terrier was in there, and some other breeds, I think. Even some Pinscher breed could be added. But regardless of that, they had troubles with World Wars, because a lot of Yacht Terriers then disappeared. The breeding programs just stopped. And also, all working terriers, they don't live that long, normally. Because if they are not retired from duty when they have proven themselves, their life is so hard that each day that they engage a formidable opponent, they can die. They can also die because they're going to Earth, and the Earth collapses, and they suffocate, or they get stuck and drown if there's water below there. So just some examples why it's hard to keep working breeds alive, and there are some factors against you. So that happened, and then they had the remainder of the Yacht Terriers, and which was already an inbred product, as I mentioned there, because of the color and all the other stuff involved. They needed to inbreed it even more, and with all those inbreeding options, the base of the genes collapsed. Goedemorgen. Exactly so. So it was not as many breeds that collapse with their gene pool when there's so much demand, that everyone is just breeding them and to get money out of it or whatever, and then they place father on daughter and and son and mother and brother and sister to each other. And also only look at external features. If it looks good, it is good and we can get a lot of money out of it. That's something that has also destroyed so many breeds. And it's very much correlated to the breeds that you find in the FCE or other registration, in my opinion. But okay, that's another thing to consider. It was because of there was so limited amount of dogs and they wanted to recreate. And they had to get the best working examples to also breed that nature that they wanted to have. Because the brave will get the most exposure to dangerous elements and also the most chance to die. They had to interbreed on those individuals that have had it all. And that makes the Jacht Terrier, unlike many working breeds, to have some faults. Those faults you can have a genetic test on, and that could really help you exclude those parts. The other way, so you could select those individuals that do have the characteristics and also the other features that you really would like to see in a German Jacht Terrier, and also do the health testing. That would help. But the other way around is that you can also introduce a little bit of foreign blood. For example, if you want a little bit more holding capability, Veld Terrier can be reintroduced. It is a Veld Terrier type, Jacht Terrier, German Jacht Terrier, so that would not be a big problem at all to keep in the type. Just add some different breeds of that same type. Goedemorgen.
Hoi.
So that would be an opportunity, but just add something that is not that hugely related at the moment, so you don't need to have that much introduced. So the thing is, you could use a breed that's almost exactly the same. Or go, for example, the route of the Westfalen Terrier, which already introduced other types of fell on the Fox Terrier breeds to get it to be an easier dog with a comparable size to the Jacht Terrier. That could be a route. You could breed it to, for example, the Westfalen Terrier or the Heide Terrier, which also uses many different breeds to get it to what they want, or just add another purebred working breed like the Petterdil or another Veld Terrier type of dog. Those would be my recommendations if you still keep having troubles or you just want to revigorate once in a while, because also in almost all performance breeding programs it's not a bad thing to have some outcross once in a while. And you will see, if you do a good outcross, you can revigorate the line. And you can even keep the line breeding quite tight because you're outcross once in a while. So you could have, like, for example, a very strong line bred, healthy Veld Terrier introduced, and then perhaps three or four more, but on the huge amount of all the Jacht Terriers, it's only a drop, but it can help a lot to give some extra genes, bring back some of the recessive strengths, instead of just building on something that has flaws, and then you select even more and select even more, and after a while you have to compromise, and compromises are often not the best thing to do. So if you, for example, compromise on the best working capabilities because those dogs are the most healthy or are not carriers, that could be even more detrimental than that you keep breeding those carriers but have excellent working capabilities. So that was my analysis of the German Jacht Terrier. I really like to breed. It's a fantastic breed, but for me it would be a little bit too intense. Also, if you want to be part of your family life, and not just a working dog. So that doesn't mean it is not a fantastic dog. I think it's one of the best terriers, but for me, the Fel Terrier, the smooth-coated Fel Terrier that I have here, the Patterdale, my dog is 11 months old now, is a lot more laid back, especially in-house. They still have the intensity of a working breed, but a little bit more rest, and also a dog that is easier to be kept in-house because the dog is not that neurotic. I'm not saying that a Yachter is neurotic because it has a neural disease. Some might have, but it's more neurotic because it always wants to work and fire things up. Have a great weekend and I hope you enjoyed this video.